aside from gefilte fish and bagels and lox, there's probably nothing more Jewish than guilt. Jewish mothers in particular are known for using that proverbial Jewish guilt to motivate their children to finish the food off their plates or to remember to call home. In fact, we even have a whole holiday dedicated to it. Yom Kippur, the day of repentance, is coming up, and we're supposed to be spending the day in synagogue, fasting, praying, and feeling guilty for our sins. Yom Kippur is one of the most widely celebrated Jewish holidays. Unsurprisingly, the Jews whose observance largely consists of this are leaving the fold at quite alarming rates. Because guilt might be fun to laugh about, but it's not that fun to live. No one wants to spend their life wallowing in guilt and shame. It's painful, and it's not even constructive. Brain scans actually show us that feelings of shame flood the brain with hormones that shut down the learning centers in the brain. Our minds go blank and numb. We're more likely to give up than to focus on the task ahead of us. So is Yom Kippur really a day of guilt? Does God really want us to spend the day wallowing in shame? The Hebrew word for repentance is teshuva, but the truth is, it's a pretty awful translation. Repentance connotes guilt, suffering, penance. Teshuva, on the other hand, actually means to return. It's about hope, it's about regret, but it's not about guilt. Guilt is the voice in my head that says, I'm so bad. I sinned, and therefore I'm tainted. I'm broken. I am sinful. Regret, on the other hand, is the voice in my head that says, I'm so good. I'm so good, and I have such a pure, pristine essence, and I deeply regret not living up to that. I deeply regret doing actions that fall short of who I am, and I resolve to live a life in the future that better reflects my soul. The distinction between regret and guilt is subtle but incredibly important. When I was living in Jerusalem and training in narrative therapy, I remember learning about a technique called externalization. When a client would come in with a problem that was so entrenched in their self-definition, it was really difficult for them to change because their problem was simply who they were. When you externalize, you refer to the problem in a way that's separate from the client, leaving space between them and their problem, allowing them to renegotiate a new relationship with the problem in their life. On Yom Kippur, we engage in certain practices. We refrain from eating, drinking, washing, anointing, and marital intimacy. Through the lens of guilt, these practices can seem like self-inflicted punishment, like suffering meant to cleanse us from our sins. But regret provides a whole new lens. These practices are meant to liken us to angels. They're meant to get us in touch with our divine essence, which craves none of these physical pleasures. Because the truth is, in order to deeply experience regret, you need to define yourself as goodness. In order to return to your essence, you need to be connected to the reality that your essence is pure. So Yom Kippur is not a day of repentance, of guilt, of suffering, or of shame. It's a day when we're meant to connect to who we truly are, regret not living up to our potential, and resolve to live a life in the future that reflects the holiness within.